Hey everybody, welcome back to Sea of Stars, and we are in the cursed woods. Apparently there's a manor that sucks people in and captures them. That's why we traveled to Wraith Island with the other Solstice Warriors, to put a stop to it. And we were at a restaurant and we saw a woman get pulled away, and everyone else ignored it because they don't know what to do, but we're gonna try to figure out what to do here. Taken care of. Thank you. Thought I had something that would heal us all. Guess not. That sucks. No. Figures. Jump across. Hate that. This is going to be annoying. one's gone. Ooh, yeah, this is very, very useful. Definitely need to restock. We'll do three. Hope we're not too late. So if the villager went into the cursed woods, does that mean that the dweller's lair is also north of Lucent? Oh, you found a new artifact. Let me see here. What few people know today is that Nuznuku had already been banished by the time of the Great Summoning happened. The channeling had become months prior, back when the lizard folk had still had the upper hand. It was toward the end of the decade-long battle after it became clear that the Mulkin mages would be the victors. On this night of nights, the air carried early cries of victory across the archipelago. Suddenly, the very sky tore open and a giant sky serpent emerged to wreak havoc. To this day, historians argue about the origins of the sky serpent. Some say it was a monster of pure evil, stolen from another plane of existence and forced to remain here. Others believe it came from above the clouds, a once friendly creature that had been mind corrupted by dark magic. But regardless of its origins, the Sky Serpent was set to change the world forever. Back in the time of Ovates, the ritual of the elements could have been performed to control the Sky Serpent's mind. But alas, the Ovates were long gone. Earth magic being their only strength at hand, the Mulkin elementalists devised a plan to contain the threat. By carving intricate wind tunnels straight through Extol's mountains, they turned it into a giant musical instrument. Blowing through the mountain, the wind started playing a melody so pure it forced the Sky Serpent into slumber. The magic was strong, and it was believed that the world would remain safe for generations, or rather, for as long as the mountain played the true melody. For the greater good, the Mulkin gave up their study of magic and established an outpost atop the mountain. Over generations, they became expert miners, living by a pledge to keep the wind tunnels operational. The brave Mulkin have toiled around the clock ever since, protecting the world one pickaxe strike at a time. Despite centuries of stability, stories say that the magic enchantment on the wind tunnels will eventually fade away. One can only hope that the Ovates will return before then. The end. That must have been what I found in the mole cavern. Alright, time to head out. Keep forgetting to do the setup camp thing, and I can't talk to Teeks. I think she was gone AWOL for a little while. Not a long time, but a little while. Thank you. seems tough. Pretty close to being dead. Check it out. Only one thing in here. Shimmering shard. Can I equip it? Increases undead damage by 15%. Food. I hate these things. Healers. They're worse than zombies. He's a real target this time. Can go into the cave. Bone armor. Oh, I already have bone armor. Can you use bone armor? I mean, I can. But it lowers his magic defense. It's better to have general defense than magic defense. I don't know. Maybe not for bosses. Speaking of possible bosses, save it to. There he is. Hey, wait! God, where's that strength coming from? Dweller's grasp is too strong. The captain was right. Can't we go in? Maybe it's not too late. No way we'd break that barrier. Even the headmaster, we needed the eclipse to get us through. So we just give up? If we die in vain, we can't help anyone. You're right. Well, maybe it won't be too late by the time you do the cleansing. Let's head back for now. I've sure had enough of these woods. Another one already? Maybe we made it angry trying to help. We should have listened. Garl! Garl, no! Valair, hang on! That's not fair. You can't take him. Hey! I was hoping we would meet under different circumstances. Explain yourself right now. I am not your enemy. I used numbing poison to paralyze your friend's body. It was either that or let him walk through that gate. It's a long shot, but if we hurry, we might be able to fetch a soul stone. A soul stone? Enchanted gems that dispel powerful curses. Someone on this island uses them to remain free of the Dweller's grasp. If we get one, it should consume the mind control spell on your friend. I know just the place, but... Well, what are we waiting for, then? I wish I had more time to explain. Zay, are you okay? Yeah, we need to find the soul stone. First, let's take him back to the inn. We have to hurry. Over here. The shortcut will help. We don't even know this person's name, and we're letting him join us? She seems a little familiar, though. See what her combat skills are. Venom darts. It says venom darts hit all enemies. It doesn't look like it's hitting all enemies. Oh, I see. water doesn't look disgusting to be swimming in or anything. Oh, we lost the guy that tells me what they're... He must have had the thing equipped that tells us what their health is, so we don't know. Avoided these guys on purpose. This will have to do for now. Now, are you willing to risk your lives in order to save your friend? Absolutely. Then we must hurry to the Necromancer's lair. With a bit of luck, Romaya won't be home, and we can grab a soulstone unnoticed. Are necromancers really that dangerous? Romaya is one of the three sisters. They are wielders of powerful magic. One of the sisters is good, one evil, and the other is neutral. The evil one is a necromancer living on this island. She's rumored to be the most formidable of the three. As to whether or not that makes her more powerful than solstice warriors, I hope we won't have to find out. How can we get there? East of Lucent is a ferryman who will take us across the bog if we play our cards right. This is the only way into the Necromancer's lair. Okay, we have a plan. What's your name, by the way? Sarai. Thanks for the help, Sarai. I don't know what we would have done without you. Let's make haste. Girl, we won't fail you, I swear. Okay, so I think I'm gonna leave it here for now, and we will go fight the, or try to rob the Necromancer, I guess, on the next episode. We'll have more of this on Friday, and more Little Nightmares tomorrow, so tune in for that, and probably more Little Nightmares on Saturday, I'm not sure. I'm kind of keeping it open as a random spot, so stay tuned, and we'll see you next time. Later.